Good morning. Welcome to the cathedral. Good morning. Welcome to the Cathedral of the Annunciation. Jesus shows us many, many kinds of love. He showed us his love for his apostles by sharing a special meal with them at the Last Supper. Today we gather as one family to share in that special meal. As we come to the Lord's table for the first time, let us always remember the love Jesus has for each of us and to always share that love with one another. Please remain seated.
Sorry about that. Okay, walk to the center.
Thank you. gather this morning in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. You guys nervous? I am. It's been a while since I did this here. But thank you very much for inviting me back to celebrate this day with you. Long time ago, we brought you into church and we baptized you, right? And you didn't have much to say about that. Most of us, we just picked you up and did it. But today, you walked in, and you walked in by yourselves, and you walked in to come to the Lord's table for the first time. And you waited a long time for this, right? So we're finally at the table. We're finally at this day. So we start asking the Lord to help us. We start by asking for the Lord's mercy. Let's call upon the Lord. Lord Jesus, you are here because we, your people, are here. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you are here in your word, in the scriptures, for us to listen. Christ, have mercy. And Lord Jesus, you will be here in your sacrament, in your body and blood that we are invited to receive. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting. Amen. So let us pray. Gather all our prayers together. All the people we want to remember. All the people we really wanted to be here. We bring them all right now. We pray for them all. So let us pray. Lord Jesus, in this wonderful sacrament, you've left us a memorial of your passion and resurrection. Grant us so to revere the mysteries of your body and blood that we may always experience in ourselves the fruits of your redemption. You who live and reign with God the Father in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. So please be seated. And the first thing we do is listen to God's word. So we get as quiet as we can on the outside and on the inside.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter was filled with the Holy Spirit and told the nation's leaders and elders, "You are questioning us today about the kind deed in which a crippled man was healed. But there is something we must tell you and everyone else in Israel. This man is standing here completely well because of the power of Jesus Christ from Nazareth."
You put Jesus to death on a cross, but God raised him to life. He is the stone that you builders thought worthless, and now he is the most important stone of all. Only Jesus has the power to save. His name is the only one in all the world that can save anyone. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please repeat. I will praise your name, my King and my God. I will praise your name, my King and my God. I will give you glory, my God above, and I will bless your name forever.
I will
praise your name, my King and my God. I will praise your name, my King and my God. The Lord is full of grace and mercy, who is kind and slow to anger. God is good in every way and full of compassion. I will praise your name, my King and my God. I will praise your name, my King and my God. Let all your works give you thanks, O Lord, and let the faithful bless you. Let them speak of your might, O Lord, the glory of your kingdom.
I will praise
it's your name, my King and my God. I will praise your name, my King and my God. The Lord is faithful in word and deed and always near. His name is holy. Lifting up all those who fall, God rises up the lowly. I will praise your name, my King and my God. I will praise your name, my King and my God. A reading from the first letter of John. Beloved, think how much the Father loves us. He loves us so much, he lets us be called his children, as we truly are. But since the people of this world did not know who Christ is, they don't know who we are.
My dear friends, we are already God's children, though what we will be has not yet been seen. But we do know that when Christ returns, we will be like him because we will see him as he truly is. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
From the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. At that time, on the evening of the first day of the week, Jesus stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." Now they were startled, terrified, and thought they were seeing a ghost. And then he said to them, "Why are you troubled? And why do you question? Look at my hands, look at my feet, that it is I, myself. Touch me and see, because a ghost does not have flesh and bones." And as he said this, he showed them his hands and his feet. And while they were still incredulous for joy and were amazed, he asked them, "Have you anything to eat?" And they gave him a piece of baked fish, and he took it and he ate it with them. And he said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses and the prophets and the Psalms must be fulfilled." And then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated. I was was told to be quick so that I would beat the sun, and it would only be on me and not on you. So see if we can do this. When St. Luke tells the story, he says that on Easter Sunday night, the disciples didn't recognize Jesus. They almost said, "Who are you?" Has this ever happened to you? Somebody comes and says, "I remember you when you were just a little baby." And then they ask the awful question, "Who am I? Do you know who I am?" It happens to me all the time. People come up to me and say, "Do you remember me?" Well, the last time I saw them, they looked like you. They were all dressed up for their first communion. And now 10 years later, 20 years later, they're asking me, do you remember me? Do you know who I am? And I don't have a memory, and I'm no good at it. So I fake it a little bit. I try to, move around, see if I can figure out who they are. But finally, I usually have to say, you got to help me. You got to give me a clue. Give me a hint as who you are. Well, when Jesus shows up on Easter Sunday night, they don't recognize him. They're so scared. They're so frightened. They knew that he died, but how could he be here? Right in front of them. So Jesus gives them some clues. He gives them some hints. He gives them some signs so they know that it was really him and he was right there. And the first thing he says to them is, "Well, look, open your eyes. See me. Look at the wounds in my hands. Look at the wounds in my feet. It's me." And then he says, "But don't just look. Listen. Remember all the stories I told you. Remember all the words I spoke to you. Remember how I shared the scriptures with you. Listen." And then finally, he does one more thing so that they would know for sure that he was right there with them. What did he do? After he showed him his hands and feet, after he said, "Listen,"
did he say his name?
He didn't say his name. He's making them figure out who he is. But he did something. He asked him a question. What did he ask him? He said, "Do you got something to eat?" He shared a meal with them. And when he did that, they know for sure that it was Jesus. Now, that didn't just happen on Easter Sunday night way back when. That happens every time we get together as God's family, as the friends of Jesus. He always gives us a hint. He shows us a sign that he is with us. The first thing is always look around. Look. Look at the people around you. I'm right here. Especially in the people who are wounded, and the people who are suffering, and the people who are sick, and the people who are needy. I'm right here. And then he says, "Listen, remember my words," which is what we just did, right? We read his word. We remembered his stories. Finally, he says, "To know for sure that I'm with you, come and share my meal." And he gives us himself, his body and blood, to share the meal with him so we would know for sure that he's with us. We're doing that this morning for the first time for you. We gather as his family. We look at one another. We listen to his word. We remember what he told us. But now he invites us to his supper, to his table, to receive him so that we would know that he is risen, that he's alive, that he's with us, so that we would know that he will always be with us, no matter what. Sun's still on me. I'm okay. Could we stand? before the prayer of the faithful, when you were baptized, we made baptismal promises for you. We said what we believed. But on this day of your first communion, we're going to ask you what you believe. We'll ask you the baptismal questions. If you remember, the answer is, I do. Okay? So in the name of the Lord, in the name of His church, I ask you, do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
And do you believe in Jesus Christ, His Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, who suffered, died, and was buried, who rose from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
And do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? This is our faith. It's the faith of the whole church. It's the faith we proudly profess in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Amen. So now we turn our thoughts to God and to all the people we want to pray for. We put our prayers together in the prayer of the faithful.
Please respond. Lord, hear our prayers.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the world, may everyone have access to the basic in life, food, water, and shelter. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For church leaders, especially Pope Francis, may they continue to inspire everyone to do good in the world. We pray to the Lord.
For firefighters and police officers in our community, may they be able to do their jobs in safety. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those receiving their first Holy Communion, may they continue to share God's word with others just like the apostles. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are sick, may they hear our prayers of good health and heal quickly. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, may they always live in our hearts and may they rest peacefully in God's loving arms. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
loving God, we ask you to hear all our prayers. Take care of those we love. Take care of those for whom we have trouble. Take care of all your people. We make our prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. So please be seated. We'll prepare the Lord's table. Put on the table the bread and wine. There's a basket for offerings, if anybody has it, and you just come up and put it in, I guess.
Thank you.
pray that this our sacrifice might be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at our hands, the praise and glory of God's name, for our good, all His holy church. Oh, Father, grant your church the gifts of unity and peace, whose signs are to be seen in mystery in the offerings we present. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just that we give you thanks always, everywhere, O God our Father. You made us to live with you and to live for each other. We can see and speak to one another and become friends and share our joys and sorrows. So, Father, we gladly thank you with everyone who believes in you. For the saints and all the angels, we rejoice and praise you as together we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Oh, Father, you are holy. You are kind to us and to all. For this we thank you. You sent your Son into this world because we had turned away from you, no longer loved each other. He opened our eyes and our hearts to understand that we are all sisters and brothers, and that you are Father of us all. So, Father, we ask you to bless our gifts of bread and wine and make them holy. Change them for us into the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. For on the night before he died for us, he had supper for the last time with his friends. He took bread, gave you thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." Same way, he took a cup of wine, gave you thanks, and handed it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Father, we remember with joy all that Jesus did to save us. In this holy sacrifice, which he gave as a gift to his church, we remember his death and resurrection. So, Father, accept us together with your beloved Son. He willingly died for us, but you raised him to life again, and so we thank you. He now lives with you in glory, but he is also here on earth among us, and so we thank you. And one day he will come in glory, and in his kingdom there will be no more suffering or tears or sadness, and so we thank you. Oh, Father, you've called us to receive the body and blood of Christ at this table and to be filled with the joy of the Holy Spirit. Through this sacred meal, give us strength to please you more and more. Oh, Father, remember Francis, our Pope, and Myron, our Bishop, and all other bishops. Help us to follow Jesus, to work for peace, and to bring joy to others. Bring us at last together with Mary, the Mother of God, Joseph, her spouse, all the saints, to live with you and to be one with Christ in heaven. For through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. So before we come to the table, we pray as the Lord's family, just like He taught us how to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. O Father, deliver us from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus, you said to your friends, I leave you peace. My peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but look on the faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. So may the peace of the Lord be always with you. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. And blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Father, grant that we may delight for all eternity in that share of your divine life which we is foreshadowed in this present age by our reception of the precious body and blood of your Son. We ask this in his name, Christ our Lord. Amen. You did it. After all this time and all this preparation. Yes. And in the name of the parish, the church, I want to ask, thank your parents and your godparents and your family and everybody who helped bring you to this day and the Lord's table. And maybe especially we thank Mrs. Haley for all the work she did to get you ready, right? But now you're in third grade, right? This is a whole new year. At your first communion, we always invite you to come back for your second communion and your third communion and your fourth communion and for the rest of your lives, because the Lord is here and the Lord is always here. The Lord is always here to tell you about his love. So we go asking God's blessing. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let's go in peace to love and to serve the Lord. Thanks be to God. Thank you.